back to, like, why did the truck fall here, I have to think that it's largely due to the shift in the Genji meta.
8일 전 이후 트라이아웃을 거쳐서
사실 그때는 저희 팀이 이제 겐지 전략에 대한 준비도 조금 안 돼 있었고 연습할 시간도 굉장히 부족했기 때문에 좀 힘들었었던 것 같습니다.
시즌 중간에 하다 보니 시간에 쫓기면서 이제 테스트를 보았어요. 그러다 보니 이제 좀 더 시간을 가지면서 테스트를 해야 하는데 그러지 못해서 이제 그 점이 되게 아쉬웠습니다.
Hello, my name is Tayo. And I am from Tokyo. Being the first Japanese Overwatch League player feels really good. I grew up in the Japanese Overwatch scene, so I feel like I have to give back to them something, and I hope that me joining the Overwatch League reignites like this energy that the Japanese Overwatch scene needs right now. World Cup has been really impactful to my career, and that is because it lets you play with people outside of your region that you usually play against. So the first time I went to World Cup was 2017, and their playstyles are so different from what you're used to seeing, so I think that was a really eye-opening experience for me.
Taiyo is being super sneaky on the flank right now. There's a very forward defense from Japan.
Oh man, if he gets a pick before they can get in there, oh, Funky in a lot of trouble, and that is bad for Vietnam.
My contenders team played with Shock for like warming up Shock for official matches and stuff, and the first time when Shock reached out to me, it was after a warm-up that we did for them and they won. And Krusty comes into my DMs and he says, "You are an insane player. I can't wait for you to be an L," or something like that. And I was like, and what I responded with was, "I can't wait to play Shock in L." Funny enough, I joined Shock, so.
You know, our coaches, you know, saw a lot of potential in Tayo. And, you know, at this point, you know, we lost a couple of our DPS players, so our coaches were definitely keeping their eye open to potentially have someone to kind of fill in the vacant spot.
He's a very active shot caller and active playmaker, and those were things we've been lacking a little bit since we lost Sinatra, but having him on the team, I think Krusty's sort of trying to mold him into that playmaker shot caller role.
So when the announcement went live, it's like 10 a.m. or something, and my phone just starts to ring so much, like notification after notification and nonstop. I was blown away, to say the least. Like these past few weeks, I would say I've never had so much support and love, but I think that's really nice.
Tayo is fitting in. I would say he's fitting in pretty well with the team, actually. He has a pretty outgoing personality, and he really likes to talk to people and just get involved with conversation.
I would think I've been getting along with everyone. I don't know. I have this innate urge to be weird, so I think my personality, it meshes with everyone, I think, and like style meshes with everyone because I'm just my own thing, you know.
Shock, they're not giving up anything right now. Choi wants to grab right here. Yep.
Definitely on the whimper territory here rather than a bang. Time is over. The Shock sweep, and woo, that was quick.
I mean, the match versus Titans, we didn't even really think about it. I mean, we were watching it and playing it, and we were kind of joking about it, like, oh, maybe it could be the fastest, or maybe we're going to hit a world record.
I think I heard over the headset, it was like 19 minutes, 23 seconds.
Like 3 minutes faster than the old record, ZP. Oh, my. Oh, I don't think anyone's going to break this. Like, this might literally stand for years.
한편으로는 이제 추석이 복수를 하게 되어서 이제 조금 뿌듯했지만, 한편으로는 이제 벤쿠어 선수들에게 좀 미안한 감이 없지 않아 있었습니다. 투아리아 선수가 정말 경기를 이기고 싶어 느껴졌어요. 그래서 이제 저희는 정말 최선을 다해서 경기를 플레이하게 되었다 생각합니다.
딱히 느낌은 없었어요. 그냥 이기겠다는 생각밖에 없어서 저희가 너무 압도적으로 이겼기 때문에 그런 결과가 나왔다고 생각해서 저희가 좀 잘하네요 라는 생각.
제가 가장 자신 있는 플레이를 할 수 있는 영웅이기 때문에 이제 저번 밴 시스템에서 오리사가 밴을 당해서 윈선을 위주로 플레이한 경기가 있었는데 이제 그 시점에서 윈선을 플레이하다가 오리사를 다시 플레이할 생각에 이제 서로 두 영웅이 플레이 스타일이 굉장히 갈리기 때문에 마음가짐부터 좀 달랐던 것 같아요. 왜냐면 오리사 원샘이라는 소리는 그만 듣고 싶었습니다.
Smurf pops into the back. Wolf just gets deleted. Immediately crushed. No primal required.
이거는 제가 방송을 하다가 아마존에서 우연히 찾은 건데 되게 귀여워가지고 시청자들도 제가 이걸 사길 바랬어서 사게 됐어요. 네, 귀엽죠? 아까 말했다시피 윈서는 제가 제일 자신 있어하는 영웅이고 그동안 되게 보여준 적도 되게 적기 때문에 그럴 수 있다고 생각을 하고 제가 윈서를 계속 플레이했었다면은 후보에 들었을지 않을까 싶습니다.
We have what could be the Shock's finishing maneuver. Chat, they heard your cries. Super is coming in on the Genji and oh man, it's a tough feeling, Jake. Would not want to be Vancouver right now.
Super Genji BM, oh no. Everyone's talking about how Coach Krusty put Super in as BM, which is totally not true. He's been practicing.
Summer Showdown에서 파리 이터널과의 경기에 제가 이제 겐지로 플레이를 하게 되었었는데 이번 겐지 퍼포먼스, 겐지 플레이는 나쁘지 않게 잘 보여줬다고 생각합니다. 화나시지는 않으셨나요? 처음엔 화났는데 나중에 되고 나니까 사실이 아니라고 생각했기 때문에 그렇게 화나진 않았던 것 같아요.
A lot of people think that me playing Genji is like BM or it's disrespect or whatever it may be. And I get why it started because it's, you know, it's a funny thing, you know, main tank player playing a DPS, and it was kind of memed up by a lot of people, myself included, Shock included. We all kind of joked about it. But I feel like even if you look back to like last year, when we were really strong in stage two, we didn't ever give up or, you know, try to take things easy. So we don't really, you know, ease off the gas pedal too much.
That's like one of like Shock's rule is no matter what the opponent, no matter what record they come in into that week, you know, we make sure that we play every match to its fullest.
I feel like Coach Krusty understands that it's not BM and it was a legitimate decision.
일단 타이어 겐지는요 주어진 역할을 이제 누구보다 잘 수행할 줄 아는 그런 겐지라고 생각을 하고요. 그다음에 이제 슈퍼 겐지는 이제 좀 감각적으로 그 모멘텀을 이어가는 형식의 플레이를 되게 잘합니다. 딜을 최대한 많이 넣기 위해서 어떤 플레이를 해야 되는지를 누구보다 잘 아는 선수라고 생각을 해요. 그 다음에 이제 라스칼 겐지는 영리할 게임을 할 줄 아는 선수라고 생각합니다. 생각이 많다 보니 실수도 있지만 자신이 원하는 대로 게임을 끌어갈 줄 아는 그런 선수라고 생각해요.
There's definitely different play styles that set us apart. And it's all about finding the right fit for the team when it's necessary, depending on different maps or whatever the meta may be. And we just kind of swap it out where we see fit.
Our team이 이루어낸 결과로 인해서 이제 뽑힌 선수들이고 이제 그 경기력을 이끌어낸 장본인들이기 때문에
MVP가 됐다는 거는 그만큼 제가 여태까지 프로 생활을 하면서 오버워치를 하면서 잘 해가지고 그 노력한 결과라고 생각합니다.
It's great to have two more players nominated for MVP this year. I think more than anything, I'm really proud of our players that's able to put, you know, these players in the situations for them to perform to their fullest.
우리 팀의 누군가가 받아도 이상하지 않다고 생각하고 이번 시즌 오기까지 좀 패배도 많이 해서 그거를 좀 딛고 올라서서 내 자신과 우리 팀이 성장할 수 있었던 것 같습니다.
만약 제가 MVP가 된다면은 그만큼 많은 분들께서 제가 그만큼 잘했다고 생각하시는 거니까 좋게 기분 좋게 상 받을 것 같습니다.
이번 시즌 MVP 후보에 올라서 정말 영광이고 뿌듯합니다.